Hello，大家好。所以呢，我们呢今天也和大想和大家聊一聊，是关于这老外怎么就是看待中国人，怎么看待中国。而且我们在网上也可以经常看到很多的老外在说，他们说怎么喜欢中国，怎么热爱中国，但是感觉听多了也没有说出很具体的一些东西。所以呢，我也是出于好奇，然后我也想借这个机会问一下我老婆，就是看她怎么想，特别是她刚来中国的时候，然后和我结婚，然后有孩子，然后生活有10几年多，所以我也可以问一下她，她是一种什么样的看法，对中国，特别是中国人，因为我们之前聊天差不多有十几个。他比较说喜欢中国的一些原因或者理由，所以我们今天选择可能先从人物先开始，所以就是我们来聊一聊他是怎么看待中国人的，到底有什么样的印象和感受。呀，所以我会问他几个问题，所以第一个问题就会问，
你想不想 introduce 我们？
可以。然后我呢，老家是浙江的。
我老家是纽约州，美国纽约州。
所以我们现在有一个孩子，然后他现在已经睡觉了。所以呢，那好，我们以后可能慢慢可以会了解我们会分享更多。所以自我介绍的话，也现在也感觉也说不出太多的东西。所以那我先问他几个问题，就特别是我说第一个问题是，就是当你还没有来美国之前，还没有来中国之前。就是还没有真正接触到中国人之前，您对他们是一种，就是对我们中国人是，或者是中国有什么样的一种印象和感受？
那我可以说英语吗？
你可以先试一试用中文，如果中文不知道该怎么表达，你可以用英语。
好吧。我先我来中国的时候，我老家是比较小的城市，然后我认识一些亚洲人，但是没有和真正的中国人有什么关系，所以我觉得亚洲人是非常好的，非常好的人，但是我不知道，或者我没有清楚的想法，这是真正的中国人是什么样的人。
然后第二个问题是，就当你刚到中国，那时候就是真正接触到了中国人，那你是一种什么样的感受和印象？但是这个是特别是陌生人居多，就是你刚看到那些。
So when I first came to China, it was just for a few weeks, and it was in 2009, and it was my first time to travel outside of North America, outside of an English-speaking country. And so I felt really, really nervous about international travel, not because of China, but just because I didn't have any experiences to know what it was like. And I didn't have a cell phone that worked in China, so I was totally dependent. I didn't speak Chinese, I didn't have a cell phone, and I was totally dependent on people that lived there, people that understood what was going on and could help me. But so I felt really nervous about ever being by myself or having to do anything by myself because I just felt helpless and nervous. But there was one time I was in Chengdu, and I don't remember why, but I was totally by myself and needed to find my friends or some place that I was supposed to meet them or some place I was supposed to go. And I didn't feel clear on the directions, and so I needed to ask for some help. And I asked just a couple people. I didn't speak Chinese, so I was asking in English. And within the first few people that I asked, I met a really sweet young woman who spoke English and was able to help me. And not only did she give me directions, but she took me to where I needed to go. It wasn't far, but she walked with me for like 5 minutes to help me get to where I needed to go. And from that situation on, I found a lot more peace being in China and just realizing how helpful people were, how willing to be helpful and gracious they were. And also that experience really, I didn't find it over time to be unique. I found most Chinese people to be very welcoming, very helpful, and very kind.
Okay. Yeah, 这是另外的一个问题。然后第三个问题的话，我想问，就是特别是当你在中国生活了一段时间以后，已经有了中国的朋友，有自己的朋友圈，那时候你是觉得中国人是什么样？特别是当你已经熟悉了以后。
I think that I found my first impressions of Chinese people to really be confirmed that Chinese people really are, for the most part, kind and helpful and very welcoming. I think the biggest breakthrough was a slow breakthrough of learning Chinese, that just realizing how limited I had been in my friendships, and I think maybe even more so how limited I had been with the community as a whole, with China as a whole, when I was only speaking English. I had friends who spoke excellent English and we were able to have good friendships, but then as I learned Chinese, speaking Chinese really brought my overall quality of relationships with Chinese people to a totally different place and different level, to be able to interact with my favorite restaurant owners and the gentleman selling vegetables on the street, or the IE at the stationery store, or my gate guard. And I found that largely all the people around me that I couldn't talk to were also welcoming and also kind and gracious and just wonderful people.
Okay. 所以另外一个问题呢，是我想问，就是你在从开始到中国，然后到现在，就是那么长时间，就是有没有说一件让你特别印象特别深的，或者是特别感动的一件事情，就是你的中国朋友或什么让你去给你帮助你或者是什么的，类似这样的。
You want me to tell the story of our accidental first date?
Sure.
So, at that time, I didn't have a smartphone, but I had an iTouch, which I used all the time for my language study. And it had some sort of problem, I don't remember, that I needed to have repaired. And so I asked, somebody said you knew a place in Xi'an where I could get it repaired. And so I sent you a text message and I was asking you for where that place was. I had lived in Xi'an for 3 years at that time. I felt really confident going around the city. I was genuinely just asking, can you tell me where in the city is this place where I can go get my eye touch repaired? And your reply was basically, I can meet you at this bus stop at this time, if that's good for you, I'll take you there. And you ended up taking me all the way there. It was raining, you held the umbrella, you opened doors, and like the temperature blocking plastic flaps so I wouldn't ever have to touch them. You took me to buy souvenirs for my sister while we were waiting for it to be repaired. And you, I think you helped me get it repaired for like 4 hours at least that day. It was a good almost hour bus ride each way, and maybe 3 or so hours getting it repaired. And then when we got back to the neighborhood where we both lived, you asked me what I was going to do next. I said I was going to eat dinner. And you said, okay, great, let's eat at the cafeteria. And you ended up inviting me or telling me we were going to eat together and take a walk together. And then you ended up walking me all the way home.
Okay. 所以这是感觉最感动的事情吗？
I mean, especially now.
你印象最深吗？所以那还有最后一个问题是，你可以是总结一下，就是当你从在美国还没有接触到中国人，然后到中国以后开始慢慢去了解去认识，然后甚至是和中国人结婚，然后到现在，那我们结婚已经有
快
5年
4年
OK 快4年，那你就是有没有一个总体的一个评价，一个感觉，就是你觉得中国人是什么样的，在你的心里？
So many memories. Yeah, when you asked me what are the things that I love the most about China, I love the people. There are many wonderful things. We have a whole list of wonderful things that I love about China, but it's the people. If without the people, I would have come.And visited and left and never come back. But maybe the food, the people and the food,
okay,
are what kept me in China. And obviously now my family. And I don't know that I've felt that amount of welcome from any culture or any people in the world.
OK， 好了，所以今天是我们的第一个视频，然后今天可能就先到这里先结束，然后我们以后呢还会继续的更新我们的视频，因为我们选择了很多，比如说今天是说人的，然后就是他为什么喜欢中国，然后还有是中国的建筑啊、文化啊、艺术啊、食物啊，而且很历史啊，还有很多，所以我们会以后会慢慢上传这个视频，所以也谢谢大家的一个关注和观看，拜拜。